Going on elsewhere in the university on the right shop. So they also had this, so I also had to go out there. So that is how I was delayed actually coming out to the workshop. Welcome to GB Pun. You mentioned that you were here for the first time, and I hope you others will be there seeing you for the first time. Rightly enough, this university was established in 1960, being the first university to be the university of the nation. And then College of Technology, actually, one of the very prestigious colleges of the university, came into being in 1962. And ever since, for the past almost 54 years, it's gone. It's been doing a great job all the time. Scientists, professors, teachers from this particular college came up during all this time, all these years. And plus also very, very illustrious students also they were produced from this college. They were occupying very prestigious positions in and out of the country. We are proud. We are very proud of all these colleges. Almost half the strength of the students in that year. Every year at this university is from College of Technology. And they are doing pretty well. Well, Professor Prasad is a gentleman to the core, actually, you all know that. And he has been organizing many trainings, many events, off and on, and he has been requesting me many times to come and join, and I cannot say no to him for very simple reason, because he is always doing some important things for this university, for this college. When I learned about this particular topic, advanced soft computing techniques, I was thinking, because I'm not very the relevant person actually for this topic, but then I realized a few things. Well, I realized that, you know, Steve Jobs, you know, in 2010, you know, when he wrote to the guys, you know, with an iPad in his hand, you know, very few he would have been understanding, you know, or realizing this important fact that in the next 2 years, you know, sort of the core size, you see, his iPod. And, that thrice, you see, as the cost, you know, what is the iPad we are doing at that time. We are used to now using the tablets now, you know, and then you also know that the big giants like Google and Microsoft, you know, they also have to roll up their sleeves, in fact, to compete. And to compete in the world, in order that they could also stand, in fact, you know. We are seeing over the time that, you know, small is getting smaller and big is getting bigger, you know. You see now smartphones, in fact, you see, they're getting smaller and then becoming bigger and bigger, you know. And then the iPad, you know, that is becoming now smaller and smaller, you see. So this reversal is really intriguing. And now we see that in a country of 1.26 billion people, you know, you have 1 billion plus mobile users, you see, in this country. And most are, you see, Android powered also. And their thinking is also alive. They want to do things in a swift movement, whether right or wrong, but then of course, you know, they are Android powered. The other day, you see, I think about a week ago, I was addressing, you see, a workshop in the college. It was sort of an awareness workshop where some villages were, you know, they were over there, they were just participating in it. The issue was that, you see, how many of them are aware about the government schemes, you know, which are available, which have been launched by the government, and the benefits, you know, which are accrued, you know, in different schemes. So I asked them, how many of do you have the mobiles? And they were all villagers with a human hand. Bearing, I think, one or two, which all is their hand, that we do have the type of mobile, not many. But then, when you ask that, do you know what is ATM? They said, no. And suddenly, you know that this is Jan Dhan Yojana of Prime Minister, you know, whereby you have to pay a premium of just 12 rupees and you are insured for 1 lakh rupees, you know. And in the event of an accident, you know, you have to have an ATM card and go to the bank and then say and ask for a claim, you know. And they said, we don't know about this. Now, they are receiving the message, I'm sure, you see, on the mobile also, you know, but then they are unaware of these things. Now, from pizza delivery to the judiciary, you know, we know that. You mentioned about artificial intelligence, you know, they are playing it off. They are so attuned to, you know, all these things that we begin to give up, in fact, our own priority to the artificial intelligence. Human brain is in fact of creating the artificial intelligence, a sort of computer system, you know, which works, you know, closely as per wishes of human being, you know. And there have been so many advancements, so much advancement, you know, that we begin to feel at times that we are living in a world of science fiction, or if it's reality. Going to space is becoming an industry now. It's becoming a sort of commercial industry now, you know. You know that. Automobiles, you know, they have been using robotics. We know that. Human beings is walking with chips. We know that. 3D imprinted in human body is now being seen very often, you see. Now, we also are aware that, you see, an extinct human being who extincted 50,000 years ago, you can still take out the DNA from a small bone of his finger and you can exactly design a genetic code. You can easily sequence the genetic code of that extinct individual who died 50,000 years ago. You can do that. You can also know that a person, you know, who is handicapped, paralyzed, had a stroke and paralyzed, cannot respond to the response which you gave him, cannot raise his arm, cannot bring his eyes and so forth. But then you can transmit signals to him. Computer brain interface. You can do that. You give him signals and he begins to work. This is amazing. This is truly, truly amazing. Stem cell from rat, stem cell from mouse, you can generate things of your choice. So there are amazing things, you know, happening all around us. You mentioned about the decision making, vision perception. End of the day, you see, India happens to be an agrarian country where agriculture remains the foremost education since is being adopted by more than 52% population of the country. We are at the edge now, in the sense that we are asking ourselves that who produces and how we produce it, the desired quantity, the desired amount, in the desired shape, in the desired nutritional mode, you know, the food for the nation. When we know that the available agriculture again land is now shrinking, 1.41 million. It used to be for the past 25 years, it's going to go down now. The available water, you know, which used to be available in plenty, you know, is going to go down now. Not an inch of land available, additional, what has been so far available. Not an ounce of water going to be available, which has been so far available, more than that, you know. But then we are asked to produce two times more, what you're doing right now. This is the requirement, is the necessity. We speak about the improving the input use efficiency, be it water, be it fertilizer, be it seed, or be it whatever. The enhanced efficiency has to produce more productivity in order to have more production. simple. From the same piece of land, you have to produce more, or else you perish. That's as simple as that. So we say that, okay, we require precision agriculture, which means that you do exercise your resources in a precise way, in a precision mode, in fact, so that the input use efficiency is increased, the waste is reduced. For example, irrigation water, the flood irrigation water, if you give, then more than 30% of it is about you, the remainder is wasted, in fact, to drainage and all these things. We know it for sure. So precision agriculture, we need to have the best judgment in order that when to irrigate, when not to irrigate, when to spray, when not to spray, when to apply fertilizer, when not to apply fertilizer, how much quantity and in how much duration, you know, when to harvest in order that we can beat the market price, etc., etc. So those are the things which are required, wherein we will require, in fact, artificial intelligence. In order that, we always keep on saying and thinking all the time, you see, the farmer, you know, has remained poor and poor all through it. But all to all those, you know, he has fed, in fact, you know, they have grown bigger and bigger. So the essential point is this, that through the application of, you know, this computer soft skills and artificial intelligence, there is also an area where we address the requirements of agriculture also in this country. I'm pretty sure this workshop, which is going to be here for the next 1 week, all these young chaps, you know, which came all across, they came with big expectation. But then battery experts that I see, they are available for the workshop. I'm sure they will all be very satisfied with having heard you all. And they will go ahead by taking a strong message that we all have to serve the nation with a positive attitude and with optimism. I wish you all the very best and wish that you have a comfortable stay as well as well. Thank you so much.
Sponsoring this program, because without coordinators' help, it won't organize this program. And when we just set up the proposal, she was happy to provide as many funds as possible. One is spending is our big problem. So anyway, within a short period of time, we could be able to get maybe around 35 to 40 participants for this program. Even though earlier, as I said earlier, we've done it for 25, then we increased it our scope of work and also participants up to 40. So that at least, and another practical is 50% from outside and 50% from our own university, so that we'll have more interaction with the outside world, okay? Like IITs, BHU, then Roorkee, then a lot of better universities like Shantiniketan University, then Usmania University, and of course, MS University, etc. So, thank you, madam, for this, for sponsoring this program, for this equip, Oscar 2006. And I also thank our respected list of farmers, for the respect of living with us for some more days. And initial 2 days, yeah. He will be enjoying his lecture. I think some of you have already heard his lecture at Hindi Program Family. And somehow he could be able to come over here and he has accepted our invitation in spite of his difficulty, because Mr. Pannagaraj itself is a big issue. Delhi we can fly. From Delhi to here is some problem. Yes, everything went well. He could reach on time, actually. And he is with us. Because our request was going on from the last so many years, I should say. Then finally, we could make it. Sir, thank you, sir, for all the way coming from Bangalore and that too from in spite of his busy schedule, because IISc professors and being the chairing of Center for Earth Sciences, he was having another program. He left that program because he has committed here. No, I will come at any cost.
Sure.
And you could be able to join us, sir. Thank you for all the way coming from Bangalore and sharing your expertise with all our participants in our committees. And once again, I thank all of our participants and all our experts. Some of them are already here, some of them get to come, they are on the way. And also our postgraduate students, research scholars and all the participants from different organizations throughout the time. So thank you once again. Thanks to you and all. And thank you for all the Tech Cube COE for sponsoring this project and also this program. And as in the right direction, yes, we hope to disseminate the knowledge from the experts to the participants in the community. So thank you one and all once again. And now I request IT, please be here in the community.